Thank you. The question is that Amendment 12867.1 in the name of Megan Gallagher, which seeks to amend Motion 12867 in the name of George Adam on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau setting out a business programme, be agreed, and members should cast their votes now. Vote is closed. I call Pam Gossall for a point of order. I call Pam Gossall for a point of order.
I couldn't connect.
Thank you, Ms. Gossall. We'll ensure your vote's recorded. The result of the vote on amendment number 12867.1 in the name of Megan Gallagher is yes 53, no 60. There were 5 abstentions. The amendment is therefore not agreed. The next question is that motion 12867 in the name of George Adam on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau on a business programme be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The motion is therefore agreed. The next item of business is consideration of business motions 12868 on a Stage 1 timetable for a bill and 12869 and 12870 on Stage 2 timetables for bills. And I ask any member who wishes to speak against the motion to press their request to speak buttons. And I call on George Adam on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau to move the motions.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I'm moved.
Thank you, Minister. No member has asked to speak against the motions. Therefore, the question is that motions 12868, 12869 and 12870 be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The motions are therefore agreed. The next item of business is consideration of Parliamentary Bureau motions 12871 and 12872 on approval of SSIs. And I ask George Adam, on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau, to move the motions.
Move, Presiding Officer.
Thank you, Minister. And I call on Sandesh Gulhani. Up to 3 minutes, please.
Thank you. I wish to declare my register of interest as a practising NHS GP. The SNP government may trumpet in this chamber their minimum pricing policy as a so-called major success. But I would ask the Minister to say that to the families of the 1,276 Scots who died in 2022 due to alcohol. Families who are grieving the loss of their loved ones. We know that the SNP has tried one flagship approach to tackle excessive drinking, to make alcohol more expensive and so thus deter the less well-off from purchasing. For dependent drinkers on the lowest incomes, we know they are going without food instead. MUP isn't a slam-dunk success, a magic bullet, as the SNP believe it. It can't be, because alcohol-related deaths are not reducing by any credible measure. Of course, seeing the SNP spin machine in overdrive over MUP, notably with regard to a key Public Health Scotland report. The trouble is, to grab the headlines, the SNP misrepresented the facts. They spun estimates as facts, and they also implied that their resounding success was based on 40 different policies and studies, and that was backed. But this, again, is simply not true. What is clear, and this is important, is that Public Health Scotland report acknowledges there was only limited evidence. The SNP's push now to... No, I will not. You should listen to this. The SNP's push to increase MUP to 65p, which can result in an increase and a hike of 30%, disproportionately penalises responsible drinkers on a low income and those dependent upon alcohol. And if that's not bad enough, this extra money does not go to fund addiction services. Presiding officer, we all know that addiction is complex and requires a multifaceted approach, yet the SNP has one approach, and that is to put up the price. They have their silver bullet, and that silver bullet is a blank. Because what is clear, and crystal clear, is that more people, presiding officer, more people suffer alcohol-related deaths now than in 2018 when MUP was introduced. In fact, men from deprived areas are drinking more with MUP in place than before, and others are switching to spirits. The Scottish Government has failed to provide the necessary investment in prevention and treatment services. If the SNP were to ever want to get a grip, people suffering from dependence should have the right to access treatment and rehabilitation via our right to recovery bill. That is the priority, not forcing every Scot to pay more. Thank you.
Thank you. And I call on Christina McKelvey to respond. Up to 3 minutes, Minister.
Thank you very much, Presiding Officer. I'm glad for the opportunity to address colleagues across the Chamber on minimum unit pricing ahead of this crucial vote. Parliament has the opportunity to show that Scotland continues to be world leading with policies to improve the health of people in Scotland by voting to continue minimum unit pricing and to increase the price per unit to 65 pence. I implore members across this Parliament to vote in favour of these orders, in line with the views of over 80 third sector organisations, that's people working on the front line every single day, public health experts, senior clinicians who wrote voicing their support for minimum unit pricing and the proposal to increase to 65 pence per unit. Minimum unit pricing is an extensively evaluated policy. Public Health Scotland's independent evaluation estimated that during the period it considered, minimum unit pricing reduced alcohol attributable deaths by 13.4%. That's 156 people a year. That's the limited evidence that Sandesh Gulhani just used there. That's 156 lives. They also said it was likely to have reduced hospital admissions wholly attributable to alcohol by 4.1% compared to what would have happened if MUP had not been in place. The evaluation found no evidence of a significant impact on alcohol drinks industry as a whole. The evaluation also has been commended by internationally renowned public health experts, including Professor Sir Michael Marmont and Professor Sally Carswell. And that would counter Sandesh Gulhani's comment today, because this is what they said. Policymakers can be confident that there are several hundred people in low income in Scotland who would have died as a result of alcohol, who are alive today as a result of minimum unit pricing. Who to believe, Presiding Officer? I'll stick with the experts. The decision to propose 65 pence per unit is underpinned by modelling by the esteemed University of Sheffield, amongst consideration of many other factors. These are set out in detail in the published business and regulatory impact assessment, which I commended to Sandesh Gulhani at committee, but he's obviously not read it. Sheffield University's modelling suggests that to maintain the value of the price per unit and therefore to continue to achieve the public health benefits at a level estimated by Public Health Scotland's evaluation, it should be increased to at least 60 pence. However, it's clear that Scotland continues to experience significant levels of alcohol harm. The Scottish Government is therefore proposing to increase the value of the price per unit to 65 pence to further increase the public health benefits of the policy, maybe another 156 lives saved. I expect, and modelling predicts, that if this increase is implemented, it will save those additional lives. I have heard the concerns of some members on the potential effects of the policy on people who consume alcohol at the highest levels. Specialist support and treatment treatment is vital for people with alcohol dependence. And to this end, the Scottish Government provided record funding of £112 million in the last financial year to Scotland's alcohol and drug partnerships. So it's just not true to say this is the only measure that we are taking. This funding supports the delivery of services for people who are alcohol dependent, whether that's residential rehab, community-based services or other types of vital support. Presiding Officer, I implore members to vote in favour of both of these orders to reduce alcohol-related harm that continues to affect far too many people. Reduce harm and save lives. That's easy.
Thank you. The question on these motions will be put at decision time. The next item of business is consideration of four Parliamentary Bureau motions, and I ask George Adam on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau to move motions 12873 to 12875 on approval of SSIs and 12876 on designation of a lead committee.
Thank you, Presiding Officer, and all moved.
Thank you, Minister. The question on these motions will be put at decision time. There are six questions to be put as a result of today's business. The first is that Amendment 12855.3 in the name of Siobhan Brown, which seeks to amend Motion 12855 in the name of Russell Finlay on repealing the Hate Crime Act, be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The Parliament is not agreed, therefore we'll move to a vote and members should cast their votes now. The vote is closed. I call Katie Clark for a point of order.
I would have voted no.
Thank you, Ms Clark. We'll ensure that's recorded. The result of the vote on amendment number 12855.3 in the name of Siobhan Brown is yes 64, no 49. There were five abstentions. The amendment is therefore agreed. The next question is that amendment 12855.4 in the name of Pauline McNeill, which seeks to amend motion 12855 in the name of Russell Finlay on repealing the Hate Crime Act, be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The Parliament is not agreed, therefore we'll move to a vote and members should cast their votes now. The vote is closed. The result of the vote on amendment number 12855.4 in the name of Pauline McNeill is yes 20, no 97. There was one abstention. The amendment is therefore not agreed. And the next question is that motion 12855 in the name of Russell Finlay, as amended, on repealing the Hate Crime Act be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The Parliament is not agreed, therefore we'll move to a vote and members should cast their votes now. The vote is closed. The result of the vote on motion 12855 in the name of Russell Finlay as amended is yes 64, no 29. There were 25 abstentions. The motion as amended is therefore agreed. The next question is that motion 12871 in the name of George Adam on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau on approval of an SSI be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The motion is therefore agreed. The next question is that motion 12872 in the name of George Adam on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau on approval of an SSI be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The Parliament is not agreed, therefore we'll move to a vote and members should cast their votes now. The vote is closed. The result of the vote on motion 12872 in the name of George Adam is yes 88, no 28. There were no abstentions. The motion is therefore agreed. And I propose to ask a single question on four Parliamentary Bureau motions. Does any member object? No member objects. Therefore, the final question is that motions 12873 to 12875 on approval of SSIs and 12876 on designation of a lead committee in the name of George Adam on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The motions are therefore agreed and that concludes decision time and we'll now move on to members' business in the name of Ivan McKee.